सदाशिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुते स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तमूर्ते नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति गुरो वेदाश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुमहतात् प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नाय अन्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। Looking at the 32nd introduction, the 32nd sutra introduction says, "Nanu buddhya para pariyaya antakkarane kim pramanam yat prayukta samsarasya adityatah." Purva Pakshi is asking, after going through the earlier adhikarana where in the same adhikarana, last sutra actually. Yeah. So what was said is, the Purva Pakshi had given so many sutras and then that was refuted. In the end we saw the Pumstvadivattasya Sataha Abhivyakti Yogat. Because of this possibility of what? Of the Pumbhava. Pumbhava, Sthribhava, whatever it is. Such dharmas which are ingrained, they continue across the balavastha, yavanavastha, vriddhavastha. Even the sharira changes, but the sharira changing, the pumbhava or stribhava does not change. Similarly, when one goes to shushupti and wakes up, the pumbhava, stribhava won't change. And similarly, tadvat, buddhi sanyoga de, the sanyoga with the buddhi, that won't go away in Shushupti. Purva Pakshi had claimed that the Buddhi Sanyoga goes away as to what Yavadatma Bhavitvam he didn't agree with. Because the 30th Sutra said Yavadatma Bhavitvam. So as long as Yavadatma Bhavitvat, as long as Yavadatma Bhavitva remains, so the Buddhi Sanyoga will remain. And vice versa, as long as Buddhi Sanyoga is there, so long the Jeeva Bhava, individuality and samsari Jeeva Bhava will continue. Unless there is jnana which results in moksha, the Jeeva Bhava will continue and therefore Buddhi Sanyoga cannot be said to be said to have gone. And in Shushupti if you claim that it has gone, it is not gone. Just like it does not go across the Bala Yavana Avasthas, the dharmas do not go, the Pumbhava Ityadi. Similarly, this Buddhi Sanyoga, which has really caused this Pumbhava, etc. Because Buddhi Sanyoga is what actually makes a person an individual, makes Brahma individual Jiva. And then through the Buddhi Sanyoga, Vijnanamaya Kosha, one extends the association with the Stula Sharira. Thereby, the Pumbhava, Stribhava comes in. Of course, see, Buddhi Sanyoga itself would be sufficient, but Buddhi, meaning Antakkarana, we have already established as continuing across Janmas till Jivan Mukti, and actually not even Jivan Mukti, till Videha Mukti. Till the body of the Jnani does not drop off by Prarabdha in the last Janma, so long the Antakkarana will continue. Across Kalpas also there is continuation by manifesting the same thing which was there in the earlier Janma, and across Kalpas it is in the Bija Avastha. This Antakkarana is in the Bija form. This we have already established. Therefore, when you say Buddhi Sanyoga, then Buddhi Sanyoga will not change the Pumbhava, Stribhava. Pumbhava and Stribhava has come due to the Stula Sharira. Because the Stula Sharira is masculine or feminine. So what about this Antakkarana? Antakkarana is configured for the male body or the female body. because all of us can agree that the antakkarana for a woman is different, antakkarana for a man is different. We see the emotional difference, whatever is the difference. We don't want to get into details, but almost everyone, whether it is a man or a woman, they'll agree that the way the mind of a man works and way the mind of a woman works, there is a definite difference. There is a definite difference. Therefore, that will also be sufficient, because in every janma, there is a configuration of the antakkarana which will limit to the particular kind of deha, whether it is gender wise, whether it is limb wise, meaning if the or whether it is indriya wise, some limbs are missing, then the antakkarana will be configured in such a manner that it will not take a particular missing limb into account or a missing indriya into account. For example, somebody is born with the right eye not functioning, then the antakkarana will be configured so that it does not deal with the right eye. Or let's say both eyes, somebody is blind at birth, then the antakkarana will be configured in such a manner that it does not understand anything in relation to the vision, the organ of sight. Therefore, this much also will be sufficient as to buddhi sanyoga continuing, the way pumbhava, sribhava continues across the across a person growing up, similarly is the buddhi sanyoga. That would also be sufficient, meaning pumbhava continues just by buddhi sanyoga also, and across days also, within the setup of the state changing, there also these bhavas will continue. Buddhi sanyoga continuing is the resultant conclusion across waking state. Across two waking states, let's say just take waking state and sushupti avastha, the deep sleep won't take away buddhi sanyoga, that was established. Now, because we had quite some days missing, this is the background. Now, the Purvapakshi is saying, Nanu buddhi apara pariyaya. You have been saying buddhi sanyoga, but what is this buddhi really? Buddhi is nothing but antakkarana. So, another pariyaya vachi shabda. The synonym for buddhi is what? Antakkarana. So buddhi apara paryaya antakkarana. Buddhehe apara paryaya antakkarana. Antakkarana is the buddhehe apara paryayam antakkarana. Tasmin kim pramanam. Tasmin vishaye saptami. So buddhi apara buddhyapara paryaya antakkarane kim pramanam. What is the pramana to say that this buddhi or antakkarana is existent? There is something called as antakkarana. What is the pramana for that? Ask the Purvapakshi. So buddhihi apara paryayaha yasya, no, not apara paryayam, but when you say buddhi apara paryayam as a bahurihi, then it will become neuter, but apara paryayaha is a pullinga. So buddhihi is strilinga, apara paryaya is pullinga. So buddhihi apara paryayaha यस्य अंतकरणस्य तत् अंतकरणम् बुद्धि अपरपर्यायम् अंतकरणम् एंड देन कर्मधारया विल बी बुद्धि अपरपर्यायम् अंतकरणम् बुद्धि अपरपर्याया अंतकरणम् देन तस्मिन् सप्तमी बुद्धि अपरपर्याया अंतकरणे किम् प्रमाणम् यत् प्रयुक्ता. बेस्ड ऑन दिस, हैविंग स्टेटेड दिस अंतकरण और बुद्धि, यू यूज द वर्ड बुद्धि, सेज द Purvapakshi to the Siddhanti, but what is this buddhi really? It is nothing but antakkarana. And what is the pramana? That pramana has not been given. Based on which? Yat prayukta samsara syat. Based on which? Dependent on this, there will be samsara. Caused by that, otherwise, or associated. Prayukta kani prakarshena yukta. Enjoined with that, associated with that, or endowed with that, there would be samsara for this atma. इत्यतः नित्योपलब्धि अनुपलब्धि प्रसंगो अन्यतर नियमो वान्यथा. नित्योपलब्धि अनुपलब्धि प्रसंगो अन्यतर नियमो वान्यथा. सिद्धांती गिव्स अ सूत्र एज टू नित्योपलब्धि अनुपलब्धि प्रसंगः अन्यतर नियमः वा अन्यथा. दैट इज ए पदच्छेद. सो ही सेज, इफ यू डू नॉट एक्सेप्ट antakarna being there. Now, what is a pramana? Shruti can be directly quoted. But then, being a nyaya prasthana, logic is given and then shruti is quoted. Because the purvapakshi has such kind of an approach. Just while discussing, with astikas, where tarka is not used, there shruti can be quoted and that would be sufficient. But then, even when shruti is quoted, even in Upanishad Bhashyas or in Gita Bhashya, we see Bhagavan Bhashyakara would give smriti pramana also and tarka also. Many times, almost all times. So here, being a nyaya prasthana, tarka is given as the basis for discussion or agreement between the Purvapakshi and the Siddhanti. So nitya upalabdhi, anupalabdhi prasangaha. Either there will be nitya upalabdhi or there will be nitya anupalabdhi. Meaning everything that you see in the prapancha, cognize in the prapancha, you will either always see, cognize them or you will never cognize them. Nitya, nityatvena. That is the prasanga, that would be the situation if you do not accept antakarana. This is the logical conclusion of antakarana not being there. Otherwise what? If you say anyatara niyamaha, va anyata. Otherwise, va anyatha. Otherwise what? Otherwise anyatara niyamaha. Meaning there will be either of the two. Meaning there will be no avastha. There will be no vyavastha. There will be no vyavastha as to how these indriyas should function associated with the vishaya. There will be no such arrangement. There won't be such arrangement or such prakriya itself will not be possible. Anything that you claim will not be possible. How so? We'll see the details in the vritti. But antakarana has to be accepted logically also. Otherwise, there will be the prapancha. Because in the, see why? Let me give a background at least for the nitya upalabdhi or nitya anupalabdhi. So nitya will go with upalabdhi also and anupalabdhi also. There will be nitya upalabdhi or nitya anupalabdhi, that kind of a prasanga. Why? Because indriyas are tuned outwards. All the indriyas are tuned outwards and vishaya sanyoga keeps on happening through and through. Unless you physically close the indriyas, which are possible to be closed. For example, ears can be closed, eyes can be closed. But if there is a lot of sunlight, even after closing the eyelids, you won't get complete darkness. You will still see something. You may not see all the vishayas, but some light will still enter. When you close your ears also, there is some loud sound. Still, the entire sound cannot be blocked. Some sound will still enter. If it is the amplitude of the sound is less, then you may not hear when you close your eyes. But what will you do with touch? You'll have to cover up your skin if you want to avoid touch with Shitoshna. So that may be possible. Still, there will be some heat or cold. Taste, you can decide not to taste. You can close your mouth and you won't taste anything. But smell, you close your nose also, still there may be some smell. Or physically all these have to be done. Now when you are not doing them, what is the gateway for the experiencer jiva and the vishayas outside? They are connected through indriyas. That would be the case, meaning there won't be an antakarana, which is a gateway between the two, which is a bridge between the two. Now, if there is no antakarana accepted, then these indriyas will have vishaya sanyoga all the time. All the time, all the indriyas are connected with all sorts of vishayas, respective vishayas. And atma has anyway got sanyoga with the indriyas. Sukshma sharira, which includes indriyas. Now, if you do not accept that buddhi or antakarana is there, then atma will be ever connected with the indriyas ever connected with the vishayas. You will always have cognition of all vishayas continuously. There won't be any other avastha. There will be only one jagrat avastha. There won't be swapna avastha possible because indriyas will always be bombarding the vishayas onto the atma directly, and atma will never be able to go through any state. There will be only single state, any other state. So nitya upalabdhi, or what? Nitya anupalabdhi. If you say no, that will not happen, then if the indriyas, even while being connected with the vishayas, if they are not generating any jnana in atma, if the atma does not have any vishaya anubhava, rather, then it will never have. There will be no deciding factor as to when there will be anubhava. And anyatara niyama va anyatha. Otherwise, what will happen? Otherwise, anyatara niyama means anything can happen. Anything of the two. Specific detail we will see in the vritti. So, this is a scenario whereby logically you have to accept antakkarana. Idam antakkaranam avashyam abhyupagantavyam, says the vritti. Explain in the sutra, Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra says this antakkarana has to be definitely accepted even by the Purva Pakshi. Why? Anyatha anapyubhagame. Anyatha means what? If you do not accept, then what will happen? Sarvesham indriyanam swasva vishaya sannidhana dashayam nitya upalabdhi prasangaha. All the vishayas will be simultaneously available all the time. There will be no time, it will not be available. All these vishayas will not be available, and all of them will be presented simultaneously. You cannot have a gateway, you cannot have a focus. Because when you want to do dhyana, what do? You close your eyes. Why? Because eyes are contributing more than 50% of the sensual input. Most of the times we are seeing. We may not hear something, but we do see. That is why perception is the translation used, or you know, seeing. Even in Veda Pramana, Veda as a Pramana is accepted as, because the rishis had darshana, we say. Generally the word uses darshana. They may have heard, but then that is called as darshana. Even when someone says that I am very sure of this, how does he claim? I have seen it with my own eyes. So that pratyaksha generally gets translated as this visual perception. People think that is visual perception, because the most of the part is that contributing are the eyes. So whenever you want to focus on something or you want to think something, you just close your eyes. When you want to focus and meditate, you close your eyes. This is the reason. Now when the antakkarana is not accepted, then what will happen? Sarvesham indriyanam swasva vishaya sannidhana dashayam. In the case of being connected with their own vishayas, all these indriyas will keep on bombarding the information, the knowledge. Thereby nitya upalabdhi prasanga. Continuously there will be anubhava of all vishayas simultaneously. Yugapat sarva vishaya upalabdhi prasanga. That is the meaning. Yugapat means simultaneously. Simultaneously all the vishayas will be cognized by Atma, by a jiva. Why? Why so? Mano vyatirikta jnana samagriyaha sattvat. Because antakkarana, manas, which is used as a switch, that is missing now. So there won't be switching on and switching off. There is no gateway. Thereby, other than antakkarana, mana, other than manas, jnana samagriyaha sattvat. The jnana samagri, all that results in the jnana. Ingredients of jnana are there. Vishaya is needed for jnana. Without the vishaya, you won't have. See, because if what jnana? You say ghata jnana. Without the ghata, ghata jnana is not possible. Therefore, vishaya is needed. That is there. Indriyas are needed. Ghata jnana, how did it take place? You know the ghata rupa through the chakshurindriya. Chakshurindriya is present. As an example, so ghata rupa jnana will take place by the samagri of vishaya as ghata being there, and the means to the knowledge, which is the chakshurindriya, that is there. Then atma is definitely connected, therefore jnana will take place. Chaitanya will be there through and through. Chaitanya anyway is through and through, but now Chaitanya does not have any reflection to form because antakkarana is missing. Therefore, this atma being everywhere at all the times, and there is no gateway, indriyas and vishayas being there, jnana will continuously take place. देयरफॉर व्हाट नित्य उपलब्धि प्रसंग युगपत ऑफ ऑल विषयस यदि सत्यामपि सामग्र्यां ज्ञानाभाव इफ द पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग नो नो ज्ञान विल नॉट टेक प्लेस जस्ट बिकॉज इंद्रियाज एंड विषयाज आर देर एंड आत्मा इज एवर प्रेजेंट जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट जस्ट बिकॉज सामग्री इज देर डज नॉट मीन दैट देर विल बी द रिजल्ट इनग्रीडियंट्स आर देर सम कुक इज नीडेड समथिंग शुड पुट टूगेदर द इंद्रियाज नाउ आत्मा के नॉट डू इट सो पूर्व पक्षी सेज दैट नो सच काइंड ऑफ अ सामग्री बीइंग प्रेजेंट ऑल द सामग्री इज बीइंग प्रेजेंट प्रेजेंट डज नॉट लीड टू ज्ञान तदा वॉट तथा नित्य अनुपलब्धि प्रसंग सो नित्य गोज विथ अनुपलब्धि नाउ कंटिन्यूअसली देर विल बी एबसेंस ऑफ अनुभव मीनिंग विषय विल नॉट बी कॉग्नाइज एट ऑल कस्यापि उपलब्धिर न स्यात् इत्यर्थः कस्यापि विषयस्य नो विषय वेदर इट इज चक्षुरिंद्रिय विषय और श्रोत्रेंद्रिय विषय और वॉट एवर नो विषय विल बी नोन एवर इफ यू से वन विषय विल नॉट बी नोन एट वन टाइम देन नथिंग इज चेंजिंग देर इज नो गेट वे देर इज नो चेंज इंद्रिया इज देर विषय इज देर स्टिल यू डोंट गेट इट देन विच एवर बी द इंद्रिया विच एवर बी द विषय नेवर विल देर बी एनी नॉलेज अथवा एकस्य उपलब्धिम इतरेषाम अनुपलब्धिम इच्छता ज्ञान सागरी सामग्री मध्ये अन्यतरस्य आत्मन इंद्रियस्य वा नियमः शक्ति प्रबंधः अंगीकर्तव्यः देन फॉर टू एस्टैब्लिश दिस व्यवस्था ऑफ समटाइम्स वन हियर समटाइम्स वन डज नॉट हियर समटाइम्स वन सी समटाइम्स वन डज नॉट सी वी सी द केस इफ योर माइंड इज इन्वॉल्व इन सम विचार द क्लास गोज ऑन बट वी डोंट अंडरस्टैंड वी आर सिटिंग देयर इन द क्लास इज गोइंग ऑन The speaker is talking, the teacher is teaching, whatever is the scenario. But then, oh, did you say something? Even if your friend is talking, oh, did you say something? My mind was wandering or anyatra manaha abhuvam. So, my mind went elsewhere. I was someone whose mind was running elsewhere. Therefore, I didn't hear. This is very well known to everyone. Shruti also says that. Thereby, antakarana is needed as a switch. If the mind is tuned out, then vishayas being available, indriyas connected with them, still the antakarana switches off. Connection with the outside world. That is why meditation is possible. Otherwise, dhyana, nididhyasana would be bahuduram. But if you still want to say, no, there is, nitya is not possible. This nityatva is not there in upalabdhi or anupalabdhi. There is some vyavastha possible. How? The Purvapakshi says, athva ekasya upalabdhim itaresham anupalabdhim ichchata. By someone who desires the anubhava of some, meaning the cognition of some, knowledge of some vishayas and no knowledge of some other vishayas, then what is the differentiating factor? Indriyas are definitely there. Then you'll have to talk about some shakti within the indriyas. Then what? Jnana samagri madhye. Within the jnana samagri, you have to differentiate. Anyatarasya atmana indriyasya niyama. Either you have to say indriya has to be controlled or atma has to be controlled. Atma should be disconnected from indriyas or indriya should be disconnected in some manner. Something should be regulated. If none of these samagris are regulated, then there will be nitya upalabdhi or nitya anupalabdhi. If the Purvapakshi says that some regulation, definitely there is a difference in jnana, it will not be continuous abhava or continuous bhava, then he has to say either atma is regulated or indriya is regulated. Kasyapi niyamaha vaktavya. Then if you accept that, state that, okay, such is the case, then you will have accepted that. What will happen? Shakti प्रतिबंधः अंगीकर्तव्य आत्मशक्ति शुड बी रिस्ट्रेंड और इंद्रिय शक्ति शुड बी रिस्ट्रेंड कैन इट बी डन रियली आत्मशक्ति कैनॉट बी रिटेन यू नो इट कैन यू कैनॉट कंस्ट्रेन इट इंद्रिय शक्ति ऑल्सो कैनॉट बी रिस्ट्रेंड ऑन इट्स ओन इंद्रिय हैज सम शक्ति वेन यू आर बॉर्न वेन यू आर एजिंग वेन यू ग्रो बेस्ड ऑन द फूड इनटेक और वॉट एवर एक्सरसाइज ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ द वे इट इज यूज वेयर एंड टेयर इंद्रिय शक्ति विल कीप ऑन ग्रोइंग और डिप्लीटिंग You have no control over it. You cannot say, oh, Indriya Shakti, I'll control just by choice. Where will you make the choice? Another thing is, where will you make the choice if Antakarana is not there? therefore shakti prabandha angikartavya, you will have to accept some restrainment of the shakti, atma or indriya shakti. Sana sambhavati, that is not possible. Nirdharmaka atmani shakti rabhavat, why atma shakti cannot be controlled? Because atma cannot have shakti itself, because atma is nirdharmaka, shakti is a dharma. That shakti dharma cannot be there in the atma. When we say maya is paramatma shakti, it is superimposed, it is not really there. Maya shakti is also superimposed because nirguna brahma cannot have any shakti also. Saguna brahma, by association, by superimposition, by some kind of an anumana, we say brahma should have some shakti. That is not nirguna. Nirguna cannot have shakti. So nirguna plus shakti is saguna, so saguna has shakti, nirguna cannot have shakti. Similarly, atma is nirdharmaka. Nirdharmake atmani shakteh abhavat. Then, napi indriyasya. Can indriya shakti be restrained? No. Why? Siddhanti says no. Shakteh anya, shakteh antaratvena tad dharmatva yogat. See, shakti is within the indriyas itself. You cannot separate it out and say, I'll control it. In fact, there is no way that you can show shakti and shaktimana is different. Nayayika says that there is samavaya sambandha. They are different, but there is samavaya sambandha, nitya sambandha. How can you control the shakti within, which is within the indriya? You cannot. Therefore, there is no restraining possible of the indriya shakti also. So now what remains? Vishaya anyway, vishaya you can take away, you can bring in, but all vishayas cannot be taken away. Vishayas will be there. Therefore, vishaya, indriya and atma are all samagri to the jnana. So there has to be continuous jnana or continuous abhava of jnana. Tasmad vasanga sthale ichha eva niyamika. In cases where you know that there is a difference in the sense, vishayas are there, but you know, sometimes you know, sometimes you do not know. So sometimes there is a sangha, there is sometimes asangha. So vasanga stare ichha eva niyamika. The desire to listen to the talk, the desire to see ghatapadadi, the desire to taste something, that itself is the contributor to restraining. That itself is the one that controls. And where is this ichha taking place? In the antakarana. So antakarana has to be accepted. You desire something more, therefore the mind wanders. Now let's say I am saying something and my mind is focused on something else. It can be some other unrelated topic or something related. Maybe I am planning something ahead, or I should have said this, or I forgot something. I am trying to recall some mantra that I wanted to quote it, and then I cannot recall and my mind starts wandering there trying to recall. Then what happens is that the focus on the particular topic that I am discussing right now may be lost. So I may make mistakes. Why? Because my desire is to get the mantra which I have forgotten. The ego says, oh, how can you forget? Bring that mantra back. So I am trying to recall that. The memory is functioning there. The antakarana plays the role of memory also. It is following that thought, chain of thought. So this chain of thought in what should be spoken, that goes away, and thereby the desire not being there strongly, I start making mistakes. Where is this desire? This desire is not in atma, it is not in the indriyas, and it is definitely not there in the vishaya also. So something has to be accepted where desire is niyamika, ichha is niyamika. Tasyascha manodharmatvena, that the desire is going to take place in the mind, it is the antakkarana dharma, therefore manodharmatvena tad anyatha anupapatya. Without the antakkarana, this kind of desire itself is not going to be possible. And since desire is there, therefore antakkarana should be accepted. This is the anyatha anupapatti, arthapatti pramana. Otherwise not possible. Without antakkarana, desire wouldn't be possible. And since desire is possible, therefore antakkarana should be accepted, because it is antakkarana dharma. So it's a three-step process. Anyatha anupapatti, here is what? Desire, ichha, is the dharma of antakkarana, manas. and desire is taking place. Without the antakarana, it wouldn't take place. Therefore, antakarana should be accepted is the third step there. So that is anyatha anupapatti. Just like devadattasya pinatvam. Kutaha ratri bhojana is landed on by anyatha anupapatti. What kind of devadatta is this? He is a pina. And what kind of devadatta further who does not eat in the day? So diva abhunjan diva abhunjanasya devadattasya. One who does not eat during the day, that kind of devadatta is still stout. Pinatvam kutaha, because he eats at night, otherwise not possible. So similarly anyatha anubhavatya kama sankalpa ityadi shruti, and finally shruti is quoted. What is that? Kama sankalpa, hrir dhir bhir, all these are what? These are dharmas of antakkarana, says the shruti. Ityadi shrutyacha siddham antakkaranam. Antakkarana is definitely established by logic also and shruti as pramana. Tat prayukta, it was asked, yat prayukta samsarasyad tasmin antakkarane kim pramanam. So he says, yes, pramana is there. Tarka as well as anumana as well as what? Anyatha anupapatti. Anyatha anupapatti in Vedanta, it is all logic, but then anyatha anupapatti is differentiated from anumana. So anyatha anupapatti, because of this also and shruti pramana also, antakkarana is has to be accepted. Siddham tat prayuktascha means antakkarana prayuktascha atmani anutvadi samsara iti. This anutva talk that the shruti makes, that is all samsara, and that samsara is possible within and outside. All this is possible because of antakkarana being there, and the tadatme sambandha with antakkarana continues the already existing samsara. Tasmad aupadika anutva shrutya na vastava sarvagatatva shrutehe virodha iti siddham. So if you recall, this is the sandarva in which all this, this is the underlying topic in which all this discussion has taken place, as to avirodha adhyaya shows avirodha between what and what. So virodha na, meaning avirodha, between the anutva shruti, atma being anu has been talked about, with the upadhi. So upadhika anutva shrutya, the sarvagatattva shruti has no virodha. Sarvagatattva Shruti talks about this Vyapaka Atma. There is no Virodha where Vyapaka Atma is real. Vyapakatvam is the reality of Atma, whereas Anutva is by Upadhi, the Buddhi Dharma. Itham cha Anutvam Paranudya Sarvagatattvam Swayanjyotishtvadi Vat Bhaishtam Prasthapitam. Introducing the next Kartradikarana. Kartradikarana, the Vritti says, itham cha, in this manner, anutvam paranudya, having taken away this anutva as the swarupa of atma, having refuted that, sarvagatatvam swayan jyotishtvadivat bhaishtam pratishthapitam. What has been established as sarvagatatva? The atma, atma tattva is vyapaka. And this swayan jyotishtvat, what, like the Swayam Jyoti Swarupa of Atma, Sarvagatattva is within and without. It is all through and through. Atma is all pervasive. Bahishtam Pratishtapitam. It has been established. Like what? Like Swayam Jyoti Swarupa of Atma, which was established earlier. So just like Atma's Chaitanya Dharma has been established as a Swarupa, similarly Sarvagatattva has been established by refuting what? Anutva. Aduna tato bhaishtam kartrutvam buddhi kartrutva vyasedhena sadhayati iti antar bahir bhava sangatya idamaha. Now there is an antar bahi bhava sangati, within and outside. How? The tataha bhaishtam kartrutvam, this kartrutva is for the atma. Which atma? This jivatma, who has become the jiva individual by association with the upadhi. औपाधिक अणुत्व हैज बीन मेंशन्ड सो औपाधिकत्व हैज बीन अटेन्ड देयर बाय इज अ संसारी जीव एंड दिस जीव हैज टू जीव इज चैतन्य आत्मा हू इज विथ एसोसिएशन एज उपाधि ऑफ दि शरीर शरीरत्रय सो बुद्धि इज नॉट दि कर्त्री बुद्धि कैन नॉट बी डूइंग एनीथिंग बाय इटसेल्फ बिकॉज इट इज जड़ा सो हू हैज टू बी टेकन एज दि संसारी इट इज आत्मा हू इज संसारी आत्मा बाय स्वरूप इज असंसारी इज नॉट अ संसारी बट स्टिल शास्त्र व्यवस्था इज फॉर दैट जीवा दैट आत्मा विच हैज टेकन जीव भाव नॉट दैट आत्मा विच इज हैज परभाव बाय परात्मा और परमात्मा बट जीवात्मा एंड जीवात्मा बाय एडिंग दिस जीवा एज अ क्वालिफिकेशन विच इज वॉट जीव प्राणधारण इज प्राण एंड ऑल इज नॉट देर इन दि परमात्मा प्राण इज देर ओनली इन जीव बिकॉज जीव धातु जीव जीव प्राणधारणे इज दि धात्वर्थ इट सेल्फ सो प्राण इत्यादि आर दि सूक्ष्म शरीर धर्म स्थूल शरीर धर्म एंड बेसिकली शरीरत्रय धर्म बाय एसोसिएशन विद दि शरीरत्रय दि आत्मा हू इज अदरवाइज रियली बाय स्वरूप पर हैज बिकम जीव इंडिविजुअल अपर Therefore, this Atma who is sentient has to be the Karta. Because Phala is given to this. Buddhi is not going to get the Karma Phala. Karma Phala is for this Jiva. Therefore, this Jivatma is the Karta. Buddhi Kartrutva Vyase Dena. Buddhi is not the Kartri. Taking away the Kartrutva for the Buddhi, what has to be, what is established? Sadhyati establishes, the Sutrakara establishes the बहिष्टम कर्तृत्व इस कर्तृत्व इज नॉट ए स्वरूप जीवा स्वरूप इज नॉट कर्तृत्व बट बुद्धि स्वरूप इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ कर्तृत्व देन हूज स्वरूप इज कर्तृत्व कर्तृत्व इज सुपर इम्पोज अपॉन द सुपर इम्पोज एंटिटी द एंटिटी इज नॉट रियल आत्मा इज एसोसिएटेड विद द बुद्धि एंड समहाउ बाय मिक्सअप देर इज कर्तृत्व बॉर्न बट इट इज नॉट फॉर द इंडिपेंडेंट बुद्धि विच इज जड़ा देर इज If you have to pick between all of these, then you have to say Jiva is the Karta because Shruti says that Phala will accrue to this Samsari Jiva. This is how he becomes Samsari. Does karma? He cannot avoid Phala or he wants a particular Phala, therefore he has done karma and thereby Phala will keep on being accumulated and being will be distributed in time to this Jiva across Janmas in various Shariras and various Deshakala. Thereby कर्तृत्वं बहिष्टं कर्तृत्वं साधयति इति अंतर्बहिर्भाव संगत्य इदमः Thereby कर्तृधिकरणं has come up कर्ता शास्त्रार्थवत्वात् कर्ता शास्त्रार्थवत्वात् सो शास्त्रार्थवत्वात् there is no पदच्छेद needed कर्ता why आत्मा इज कर्ता why शास्त्रार्थवत्वात् because शास्त्र अर्थवत् what is मतुप there शास्त्रस्य अर्थः प्रयोजनम् अस्य अस्ति अस्मिन् वा इति शास्त्रार्थवत् शास्त्रार्थवान् आत्मा नॉट आत्मा शास्त्रार्थ वत् मीनिंग शास्त्रार्थ एंड तस्य भाव शास्त्रार्थवत्त्वम् तस्मात् हेतोः शास्त्रार्थवत्वात् आत्मा हैज टू बी कर्ता व्हाई Otherwise, Shastra will not have prayojana. So, the Hetu is given, Shastra has to have prayojana because Shastra has prayojana for this Jiva. So, we can say Shastrarthavan. Atma is Shastrarthavan because Atma, for Atma, Jivatma, Shastra has a purpose, meaning. Because the Shastra is for the Jiva. All the Purusharthas are for this Jiva, Purusha. Shastra revealing the dharma and the moksha, which are not possible otherwise. For that, Shastra is the only pramana. So, Shastra has prayojana. Therefore, Shastra prayojana means artha. The word artha stands for prayojana. So, Shastra's artha prayojana is there for this particular purusha, for any purusha, any jiva. The other two purushartha's also. Should be led by dharma and moksha in mind. Nothing should take away dharma. Otherwise, one will not be led to moksha. Therefore, artha and kama also should be led by dharma. artha should be accumulated for dharma's purpose alone. Thereby one can get more and more, the kama should be led, one can lead the lead oneself and the family or the society, or we should focus on oneself because purusharta is for oneself. So one should lead such a life that dharma guides a person to accumulate artha in such a fashion that they will be used for the dharmika kamas and thereby led to chitta shuddhi, leading to chitta shuddhi, they culminate in moksha. Finally, leading a person to jnana and jnanena moksha. This is the setup. All these are revealed by the shastra. Because artha and kama are there in other living beings also. But if we live like other instinctual beings, meaning those who just have, instinct to live, procreate, so on. These artha and kama are there for others also. But we should utilize the shastra so that we configure the artha and kama in such a manner, or our mind in such a manner, that artha or kama are led by dharma. Thereby, moksha will be the resultant in time. And therefore, for whoever is the prayojana of the shastra, that entity should be the karta of the karmas which are revealed in the shastra. So karta cannot be buddhi, because for buddhi the shastra is not having prayojana. That is the sutra artha. Atra tadguna saratvasya eva prapanchanat atra mitashrutyoho virodha pariharo na vicharaitavyo. What the Purvapakshi, not the Purvapakshi, what the Siddhanti is saying in this sutra is that what he is saying, karta is atma, meaning what? Na buddhi. Purvapakshi is saying buddhi. So atma eva karta, na buddhi kartri. Kutaha shastrarthavatvat. What is that? Kartuhu apekshita upaya bodhaka vidhi shastras. The vidhi nisheda shastra is what? Apekshita by what? Apekshita, there is an upaya which is apekshita, and that is revealed. Bodhaka is a shastra of what? Vidhi. Vidhi nisheda ityadi. By vidhi nisheda is also included. So apekshita upaya bodhaka vidhi shastrasya arthavatvat prayojanavatvat ityartha. That is the sutra artha. Now the Siddhanti is saying, why has this sutra come up without any sangati? I mean, sangati has not been explained. What kind of a sangati? Or there is no discussion as to meaning the antarbhai bhava sangati has been mentioned, but you have not talked about what is the avirodha here, what is the virodha here. So there a specific virodha, avirodha has virodha and avirodha, virodha by the Purvapakshi being pointed out and avirodha established by the Siddhanti. This specific thing is not needed in the sutra. Why? Because this is a continuation of what? Tadguna saratvasya. So there is a tadguna saratva sutra which has gone by. So tadguna, you look at this earlier, there is a tadguna. So this tadguna, 29th sutra, tadguna saratvatu tadvyapadesha prajnyavat. Whatever was the virodha there, that is the same virodha being shown by the Purvapakshi. And Siddhanti is pointing out this a similar avirodha. The differences are there, but then differences are there with the same topic. Within the same topic, there are differences in sutra being the buddhi being the focus, or atma being the focus, to establish karta. Who is the karta? Therefore, tadguna saratvasya sutrasya. Tadguna saratvasya, in that sutra, there is tadguna saratva pada. Of that pada itself, or that sutra itself, there is a prapanchana, there is an elaboration in this sutra. Therefore, prapanchanat atra mitashrutyoho virodha pariharo na vicharitavyo. Whether there is a mutually there is virodha, avirodha between shrutis, that should not be talked about. That need not be discussed, need not be inquired into. Why? Because of the same reason. Tadguna saratvasya, there we have discussed, there is no change in topic there. Kintu atmana kartrutva akartrutve. So what is the difference which has to be inquired into? The difference in inquiry is whether buddhi is kartri or atma is karta. Who is the karta? Kartru kaha or ka. Tatra kim buddhi kartri uta jivaha iti sande. So buddhi kartri uta jivaha karta. Based on the linga bheda, kartri or karta. Iti sande, whether buddhi is the agent of the action or jiva is the agent of the action, subject of the action. Sandehe prapt. When there is a doubt, parinamitvad buddhi riti purva paksha. See, whenever there is a karma being done, then that karma will cause some change in the karta. Whenever someone does an action, there is some change in the actor, in the agent. Therefore, parinami is who? Atma is not parinami. Atma does not undergo change as per the Purvapakshi, who is saying that Siddhanti himself has claimed that Atma does not undergo any change. Then how can Atma be karta? So he is saying that as per your own Siddhanta, Vedanta, Atma cannot undergo change, and karma, somebody who is doing karma, that somebody will undergo some change. So parinama will be there. Therefore, buddhi, which is parinami, that has to be kartri. Atma cannot be the karta. Siddhantastu atma eva karta na buddhi. Siddhanti says no, atma is karta. Which atma? Who has upadhi sambandha? Upadhi ka sambandha, tadatme sambandha with the upadhi, that atma is the karta and can undergo change. So kutaha kartruhu apekshita upaya bodhaka vidishastrasya arthavatvat. I have not marked all of these. I mentioned this in the sutra explanation, mula. But then mula has not been marked here. Arthavatvat is from the part of the word in the sutra. So shastrasya arthavatvat is the samasa vicheda vigravakya. Shastra arthavatvat means shastrasya arthavatvat. What shastra are you talking about? Shastra is apekshita upaya bodhaka vidhi. Vidhi shastra. That shastra which is vidhi shastra, which talks about vidhi. And what is that vidhi? Vidhi is a bodhaka. Bodhaka. Vidhi is pullinga. Ki pratyanta pullinga. It sounds like in Hindi, ityadi, in some other languages, it may be strilinga. Like samadhi. Samadhi is strilinga in Hindi, but samadhi is ki pratyanta, it is pullinga in Sanskrita. So this vidhi is pullinga, so it is bodhaka. It is revealer of what? Revealer of upaya, which is apekshita. For whom it is apekshita? It cannot be apekshita for buddhi. Who expects this revelation by shastra? Atma accepts, jiva accepts. Jiva expects it. So apeksha is there for the jiva, not for buddhi. Thereby, apekshita upaya bodhaka vidishastrasya arthavatvat means to anything is revealed by the shastra. You do this karma for swarga, you do this for putra, you do this for dhana, you do this for shatrumarana, whatever. If you want to do it, you do it. Shastra does not say that you do it, you have to do it. Shastra says if you think that you are this kind of an entity who wants this kind of a thing, then if you want, you can do it. I'll tell you the means. That is the approach of the Shastra. All lakaras are late or vidhi in Shruti. Therefore, Karmakandi will say all these are vidhis, vidhilinga. They have vidhiling meaning. Late has vidhiling meaning. All of these lat lakara, vidhiling, lit lakara, whatever it is, lung lakara, every lakara in Shruti will be vidhi. It will be late. It will be taken as the form of late lakara. So if there is a lat lakara occurrence, then karma kanda will say that lat lakara has no lat meaning. Vartamana kala meaning is not there. Then what is the meaning? He'll say late meaning. It's a late form, and late has the vidhi meaning. Vedanti, Siddhanti will say all of that is fine for karma, but from the perspective of jnana, when jnana is the focus, then all of this is what? Is optional. In fact, every lakara, late lakara is true, but late lakara will not have vidhi meaning anymore, because vidhi is only for a person who is identifying with the sharira. Because the विधि विल बी फॉर हुम, विल बी फॉर फॉर अ समबडी हु हैज वर्ण एंड आश्रम. दिस वर्ण एंड आश्रम आर बोथ रिलेटेड टू दी शरीरत्रय, बेसिकली दी स्थूल शरीर. स्थूल शरीर इज बॉर्न इन अ पर्टिक्युलर वर्ण एंड एंड देन कंटिन्यूज इन अ पर्टिक्युलर आश्रम. Therefore, rules have been talked in the Shruti. A person who identifies with that sthula sharira will have varnashrama and has to follow. But if he does not identify by jnana, then all of these lakaras will have no meanings. Whether it is late, vidhi, lat, lung, ling, lung, all these you are considered as vidhi, having vidhi meaning pradhanya, all that has no meaning. So the jnana kandi who has focus in only jnana, he has no karma adhikara at all, because varnashrama itself is not there. All this varnashrama has to be dropped. So where is the Shruti having vidhi for that entity? Anyway, that's an aside. But Shastra will be arthavan only for that jiva, whether he is looking for moksha or looking for any laukika phala with the alaukika upaya. That alaukika upaya is also revealed by the shastra with the vidhi ityadi. So yadi buddhi kartri, if at all buddhi is taken as the agent of action, then phala bhokta cha atma itti uchyeta. You have to say that the phala accrues to the atma. Who is doing the karma? Buddhi is doing the karma, purva pakshi is saying. But who gets the phala? Atma gets the phala, because jiva is going to get phala in the is this janma or next janma. Then buddhi is doing the action and jiva is getting the phala. What kind of arrangement is this? Chaitra does it and Maitra has to face the, gets the phala, whether good or bad. So we'll say if he gets the phala which is desirable, then Chaitra does the karma, Maitra enjoys the result. If Chaitra does something, the punishment goes to Maitra, then we'll say Maitra suffers. Like the friends, you know, friends, in school friends, they play some mischief. Somebody does the mischief and somebody else has to play because he didn't outrun the other. Chaitra ran away doing some mischief and Maitra has to pay. Or Chaitra did something and was not available, Maitra got the result. So something was done very well, Chaitra is not there, Maitra gets the result, he claims the result. What kind of an arrangement is this? It is not right. And that Ishvara should not definitely do. Ishvara is karma phala data. He cannot give result to atma when buddhi is kartri. Tarhi tadrusha vidhi shastram anartham. And shastra says you do this. Ishvara through his own vachana has promised that if you do this karma, then I'll give you this kind of a result in this janma or another janma. But definitely result will be there. And buddhi is doing the karma and this jiva is not getting the jiva is getting the result. Then tadrusha vidhi shastra will anartha, because buddhi does not want phala also. If buddhi is doing something, the phala does not accrue and won't get also, because buddhi is jada. So this shastra which is tuned towards the jiva will be meaningless. Thereby tadrusha vidhi shastram anarthakam apadyeta ataha na kevala buddhe kartrutva. So this kevala word is important. Buddhi has kartrutva with by association with jiva, but the kartrutva is not in buddhi. Kartrutva is in atma, but buddhi is also samagri there. Without antakarana, the pratibimba won't take place, abhasa won't take place. There was jiva who is abhasa or pratibimba, cannot exist at all without buddhi. Therefore buddhi is definitely samagri. Antakarana, without antakarana, this jiva won't exist. Jiva is an unholy, so to say, mix up of atma, chaitanya atma and jada buddhi, as though unholy mix up. That mix up which can never take place has taken place. Viruddha dharma yo, we have seen in Adhyasa Vashya, chaitanya and achetana are like tamah prakashavat, viruddha svabhavayoho. Cannot have this anyonya adhyasa, but sambhavati. It is already existent. What should not be possible is already there. So that is the, so it is mithya. Natu atmanaha. So kartrutva is सॉरी अपितु आत्मनः, अतः न केवल बुद्धे कर्तृत्वम् अपितु आत्मनः, विच आत्मा दैट आत्मा विच इज नॉट केवल आत्मा ऑल्सो इट हैज एसोसिएशन विद दी बुद्धि सो दैट इज ए जीवात्मा किंच विहारोपदेशात विहारोपदेशात फर्दर दी सूत्र सेज दैट देर इज अ विहारोपदेश देर इज अ टीचिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर जीवात्मा हू has vihara. What vihara does he have? In swapna, he goes around. In jagratavastha, there is some samskara form, whether in this janma or earlier janmas. What has happened is that this jiva has accumulated samskaras. He may or may not act them out in the jagratavastha. But those samskaras want to manifest because he has done such karmas. They have got engraved so much that automatically those particular thoughts come up. You don't have a choice over thoughts, emotions. Those emotions take place. You can just try to do something that will not give rise to such an emotion. But beyond that, you don't have any control because samskaras will keep on triggering emotions and also the thoughts. So if you tell someone, oh, don't think like that. What control does he have? Don't think like that means, oh, I will think on this Vishaya, then don't think on a particular Vishaya is fine. But that Vishaya comes to the mind, there is no control there. He does not want to think, but the thoughts come. He does not want to have this sadness. Who becomes sad by choice? Only a sadist would do that. So generally we'll say, oh, prayana what? You know, everyone wants to be happy. And prayana what? Generally no one will think of some sad things which will make them sad. So they'll avoid such thoughts. But samskara is such that such thoughts come and make this person sad because karma is due. He is supposed to have dukkha. Based on his earlier karma, he or she is supposed to have that dukkha in that circumstances, based on that vishaya, in that time. So these thoughts will come. What can he do? He can withdraw. A person can withdraw saying that, I have nothing to do with these thoughts. Whether it is kama, krodha, whatever, lobha, moha, I have nothing to do with it. So disconnect can be cognitively there, but he cannot say that thoughts should not occur. With chitta shuddhi, the thoughts will be countered. Samskaras will be countered by samadhi ityadi. But then one cannot have control directly over the thoughts. But still, this jiva has control in swapna. What is he control? He does vihara. Whatever this jiva could not do in the jagratavastha, or maybe did a lot earlier or kept on doing now also, in the swapna avastha it will start manifesting. And what is that manifestation? This particular jiva himself chooses to pick up his samskaras and have swapna prapancha. He creates. That is the vihara. What's a good vihara? Vihara can be, you know, wandering about or something like that. That kind of a translation would be fine. Vihara. It's a play, basically. Some kind of a krida kind of a meaning is there. Some play. Leela. The way you say that prapancha is Bhagwan's leela, the swapna is jiva's leela. Upadesha, there is a teaching like that. This person, this jiva in swapna, has a sports about, based on what? Based on the samskaras. So because there is such a revelation in the, so upadesha can be taken as revelation in the shruti. So viharasya jivasya atmanaha viharasya upadeshat. Vritti se sve sharire yatha kamam parivartate iti jiva prakarane swapnavasthayam viharasya sancharanasya upadeshat. Because the shruti says that in the jiva prakarana, in the section of the shruti where jiva is being discussed, in that kind of a context, what does the shruti say? Sve sharire yatha kamam parivartate. This jiva undergoes some change. What kind of change does the jiva undergo? Yatha kamam. Based on the samskara, as one desires, such is the change. That's why in jagratavastha, one may not be able to do everything to accumulate something, whatever it is. one may not be able to fly, obviously. Let's take an odd example. One wants to fly, has some samskaras, oh, I would love to fly. Wants to become a pilot, because that is the only way you can fly. So he wants to be a pilot, or he wants to earn enough money to, you know, take helicopter trips or whatever it is. He wants to somehow, you know, fly, have a bird's eye view. Some bird samskaras are there, something we can assume there. Or wants to look at the entire, you know, the top view of the of Himalayas or whatever it is. Wants to appreciate that beauty also, such samskaras are there. Cannot trek, but wants to have the view, so I would have a top view when I have enough money. But he cannot make that money in this Jagrat Avastha. So what does he do? In the Swapna, he starts flying, whether as a bird or whether as a human being, irrelevant. But then, such yatha kamam, where sve sharire, how can he have a change in one's own sharira? Within how can you have change? Only in Swapna Avastha, that is the Swapna Prakarana. Jiva Prakarana is Swapna Avastha, I mean the Swapna Avastha. Viharasya, what is vihara? Samcharana. Wandering about, sporting about, upadeshat, asya upadeshat. Akartuhu sancharana ayogat atmanah kartutvam ityartaha. Thus, akarta, one is not a karta, that non-karta cannot have sancharana. So, jiva, if he is not the karta, buddhi is the karta, kartri, then what will happen? Then, this jiva will, as per his kama, yatha kama is kamam anatikramya. In keeping with kama, one's own samskaras, one has swapna. So how can he have swapna, swapna acharana charana? Going around in swapna, how is this vihara possible for a non-karta, jiva? Therefore, jiva has to be karta. Otherwise, one cannot have vihara. One cannot have sancharana. Therefore, atmana kartrutvam ichyartaha. Kincha. Kincha what? Upadanat. Upadanat. What is upadana here? See, here upadana is, accepting something. Accepting something meaning associating with something. We'll see, the meaning will be clear. It's a short vritti. I'll cover that. Prananam vijnanena vijnanam adaya iti atmanah grahana shakti upadana shravanat. Accepting that, grahana, grasping. So upadana due to grasping what? Grahana shakti or atmanah grahana shakti. Atma has this grahana shakti, upadana shakti. Of what iti atmana vijnanam adaya. Taking this vijnana, prananam vijnanena vijnanam adaya. Having taken this vijnana from what? Prananam vijnanena. So prananam vijnanena what? This atma is grasping the vijnana there. So there is a movement of the indriyas because of prana. And thereby, what is happening here is that the Atma is grasping the indriyas, and through indriyas getting the knowledge. So, iti atmana grahana shakti upadana shravanat, because this is heard in the Shruti. Shruti says that this jiva is the karta who associates with the indriyas, gets the vijnana, grasps the vijnana, vijnana madhaya, having accepted or grasped the vijnana knowledge. Akartuhu upadana ayogat. Akarta cannot have this upadana, cannot grasp. Grasping is a kriya. Whether the one partakes the knowledge, that parting of the knowledge is a kriya. That kriya is not possible for an akarta. For a karta alone it is possible. Therefore, jiva does that. Jivatma, atma does that. Therefore, atma, jivatma is karta. Atmana kartruttvam. Ataha atmana kartruttvam ichyartaha. Okay, let's stop here. I wanted to continue, but I'll see you on Wednesday. We'll appeach it. The topic continues, and we'll continue in the next part. Tomorrow is Prathama. Amnayantika samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandhanava purnamatma jyoti rupasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste.